all know why you're here this afternoon. Sophia, wake up! You are wasting your precious VCE time by mucking around all the time. Seema, get your feet off the chair! So, it's Friday afternoon and I know you've got better things to do with your time. However, there are consequences for your actions. So, I need to head out from this room and grab some cleaning supplies.
Cleaning supplies?
So, why are you guys in tension?
You know, I was like 2 steps out of the common room on my phone and bam, a teacher just came and gave me detention.
Ooh, tough luck, school cap.
I was late to class by like a minute and I didn't get a late slip.
Renee, you've been late to like every literature class this week.
Yeah, but I was rushing, so it doesn't count.
I was caught going to shell in my spare.
Classic.
I wore my scarf to the whole school assembly and apparently it's not considered as part of the official school uniform.
Alright girls, cut the chatter. The faster we clean, the faster we can all go home. Mrs. Poyser said that you need to clean up the drama room after you do this, so give me a hand, alright?
Oh, I can't believe she's making us do this.
Tell me about it.
Oh my god.
Damn, I haven't been here in a hot minute. Wait. Have they always had that upstairs bit?
Yeah.
Alright guys, I have a second Monday that I need to study for, so...
That's fine.
Okay, so why don't Seema and I take the big room, and you guys each take a smaller room?
Sounds great.
Weird.
Whoa, how'd you get there?
What?
I shall show you again.
Whoa. Everything's worried.
Black needles in the city. Be back immediately to confiscate the money.
That girl is a real crowd, please. Small world, all her friends know of me. Young bull living like an old geese. Quick release the cash, watch it fall slowly. Frat girl still trying to get in. Haters mad for whatever reason. Smoke in the air, binge drinking. They lose it when the DJ drops the knee. To explain.
I'm a black beetle, cream seeps in the Regal, rocking John Lennon lenses, like to see him spread eagle. Took a
place.
You already know what it is. Solid talk, solid talk, solid talk. Don't it do it for me,
Eleni? You're stupid.
Gosh, Alicia. I got a guess as well. Okay.
Min's face.
But maybe. Oh, this is good. Okay.
That wasn't right. That would have been so embarrassing.
I think I'm the one that's not getting this.
I think I'm making my eyes distract.
What's that thing?
Oh my god.
Iconic.
Oh my god.
Iconic moment of year 12.
Oh gosh.
The hell does that say?
Can you read, Jessica?
You can't write.
So hard being a genius.
Look again.
Grammarly does more than
it's impossible. Whoever came up with these like sentences.
This is like full essays.
We are so close.
No, you really do.
Did someone die at school?
Is it grass or is it being what?
It's Emily
dressing up with grass for.
What the?
Started off this game so strong.
and now I've just completely fallen apart.
Is that period blood?
Oh. It's paint.
Kozlowski. Oh.
And I've never seen Miss Kozlowski dance.
This is really abstract.
Wait, tell us the word and see who can type it the fastest.
Yeah, just tell us. Come on, Shannon.
Just
a pat.
Got it.
No.
Yeah.
Oh, what? Emily dressed up in grass.
Oh my god. Emily turned into Rapunzel.
Yeah. And then cuts it off.
Oh. What? Okay.
Have we seen this one?
No, not yet.
Oh.
How do I draw this?
Don't you get that? Theater kids.
Yeah.
Oh, that's fine.
Wait, I don't even know the name of the thing that you guys... What? It was something about...
Ugh.
This is really all I can do. 5 seconds.
No. It's not Picnic at Hanging Rock. It's the ghost in Barbara Sutton.
What's her name?
They named it? Yeah.
Questions with the class of 21. Today we have Mr. Paz, Mr. Loft, Miss Litchfield, and Miss Tan and Mr. Clark. And I'm your host, Seema, and I'm joined with Sienna.
Most likely to. Guess who had the most nominations by our year level in these categories?
Most likely to come back to a school as a teacher. We have A, Karen, B, Chelsea, C, Ashley, or D, Amy.
I think I'm going.
Actually, no, I'm going this one. I've changed my mind.
Yeah, I'm going A.
What's Karen going to teach? You guys are the majority.
I think that she just loves everything. Being around school.
Yeah, just teaching life lessons.
Just life, Karen. Yeah.
Right.
I think like my year 9 class, I feel like she was teaching as much as I was anyway, so she may as well do it.
And she was like my house captain this year, and she was essentially the teacher, and it was then me and Ella as like the house captains. Which was nice. She would organize everything. She would tell me where to be when I needed to be there. So it was great.
Yeah, you could ask Karen all about house, regardless of, you know, allegiances, and she'd tell you what's going on. It's a good time.
Nice. I feel like Chelsea still got a lot of votes though. Why did you guys choose Chelsea?
I chose Chelsea because I feel like she has the teacher vibe.
The answer is Chelsea.
Oh! Yeah.
Good job.
Next question. Most likely to sleep during class. We have A, Charlene, B, Alicia, C, Renee, or D, Belinda.
I've heard of this one. I've never taught this one.
I'm going to go with the consensus.
Yeah, I'll go with consensus.
Following the crowd.
I taught her in 2019. She sat at the front of the class, but I'm pretty sure that she was asleep for most of the class. So I'm going off experience.
You guys are right.
Nice. Look at most likely to be a viral meme? A, Emily, B, Manisha, C, Rianne, or D, Seema?
It makes me laugh all the time, so I'll give her that.
Seema, can I change the question to who would most likely come up with a viral meme? And if that's the case, I'm going to choose you because you've made so many great memes across the years. I swear, you know how to meme.
Thank you.
And the answer is Emily.
Mr. Clark.
She's funny. Emily's hilarious. Go, Emily.
I feel like Emily's so funny that it wouldn't even be able to be caught in a meme. Like, it wouldn't be able to be caught. She's just so, like, she's just funny all the time.
Most likely to be ID'd at 30. D for Chantelle, D for Isabel, and D for Maggie.
Yeah, she's such a cutie.
Bye, Maggie.
Look at that face. Imagine that face at 30. I can.
Are you imagining it exactly the same?
Yeah.
Although
I'd say the same about Chantel.
Yeah, that was my logic.
Good.
Oh, 10.
Oh, wow.
Well done.
10.
Next question. Most likely to be an influencer. We have A, Melinda, B, Min, C, Courtney, or D, Zoe.
We're going to go with the crowd here because I don't
know. What's up, Min? Like she already influences me. We watch Gossip Girl together, you know. I'm influenced by Min.
Well, actually, hey, Melinda.
Oh, wait, I need to know this story.
Really?
She already has like 13.5K followers on Instagram, I'm pretty sure.
No, yeah. Really?
Melinda.
Most likely to be an Olympian. A, Sarah. B, Kathy. C, Emily. Or D, Megan.
Okay, I'm going to change.
Not two.
One down.
I'm just going to go away from the crowd.
Nice.
Ooh, one for everyone. Why D, Mr. Paz?
Have you seen her throw a javelin? My God.
I think we all have from the staff room.
Yeah, from the staff room. Like when they do javelin practice, it's like right out the window. And sometimes I watch and I fear for the lives of the students walking around. Yeah.
C, M.
Oh,
how could she answer for two of them?
She's got two already.
No, that's why I changed. I was like, she can't be the answer for two.
I story try. Yeah, that's not how it works.
Most likely to remove themselves from a mainstream civilization to a remote location. We have Ashley, Catherine, Amelia, or Holly.
All of them. Mainly just to sleep, I think. Mainly just to sleep. Catherine!
Oh, what?
Yep.
Most likely to have a child.
Oh,
jeez. B, Eloise, or D, Jess?
Oh, no, actually, hold on. I changed my mind.
I'm going, yeah.
Maternal qualities.
Yeah.
Totally. I'm going with that,
Itchy. By that logic, I'm going
Chloe Langley. Yeah.
I mean, I'll just go with the crowd.
None of you guys are getting this one right. It's
most likely to win the lottery but lose the ticket.
I think I have to go with this gem.
I like A as well. I reckon A is a good choice.
Why do we say that?
You got to first win the lottery. And I think Claire has a very positive attitude and good things happen to positive people. So I would go Claire.
I like that.
Yeah.
And I won the game.
Most likely to be a wiggle. Rachel, Sophia, Zara, or Eloise?
And if we're basing it off talent, then definitely C.
Yeah, that's what
I was going for.
I'm not going off talent. I'm going off like general like goofiness.
Wiggle vibes.
Okay.
Just wiggle vibes.
You have to be organized too.
Right.
That's true.
Yeah.
Most likely to run away to Greece and live the Mamma Mia lifestyle. We have Ella, Shannon, Monica, or Sienna. Why do we say A?
Ella at the drop of a hat could just duck off and live that life.
Like she would just go up and go.
Yeah, just go.
Yeah, not really think about it. Like everything's going to be all right. Just get on the plane and go.
Yeah.
Why Monica?
I went Mon because I reckon I could picture her, you know, sitting on a beach in the Greek islands. Yep.
Nice. Well, you're all wrong because the answer is...
You need to explain this one to us.
Yeah, why?
Yeah.
Love Mamma Mia. I love traveling if I can. And I always get lit to ABBA on the dance floor at parties. People know that all in the year
long. Good to know.
You guys failed to.
We clearly didn't know
why
that,
do you
though.
Not share this with us?
Yeah, how is that something that we're just finding out now? Ridiculous.
That has come up in zero conversations. Like,
most like, oh.
Oh, no! Oh, no, it's okay. I would have gone C anyway.
I would have gone C.
I might have gone Charlotte Cootie, actually.
I'm gonna go the rogue.
I would have gone C or D. I do think that Sabrina would actually make a really quite a benevolent dictator. Like, she'd be a great dictator.
She is very what's that word? Charismatic.
Authoritarian.
Charismatic.
Most likely to be arrested. Min, Sarah, me, or Iris.
Arrested for what though?
I just got a vibe.
It could be arrested for like protesting for environmental freedom, rights.
Why D?
Mix it up.
I have no reason.
I still want to say C while you're here, but maybe you. But
no, because you'd talk your way out of it, Seymour. You'd get away with it.
Okay.
I'd be Mr. Buzz.
It entertained me the most.
The prospect of Sarah getting arrested. Right.
Yes.
You're right.
I feel like it wouldn't be her fault, but she'd just be in the wrong place at the wrong
time. That's exactly why she got arrested.
Mm.
That wraps up that. So now we have confession round.
It's time for the class of 21 to confess their sins. Guess who's the culprit behind these juicy confessions?
In the first week of remote learning, I watched an Outer Banks live stream instead of my general class.
What's Outer Banks?
It's a great TV show.
Well, did you start it?
I finished it.
I'm assuming it's my class.
Yes.
Good to know. It's good to know.
It's always handy to know who's in the maths.
Good classes. To find this stuff out now. I'm actually just going to quickly send an email to Chelsea.
Email reads, can you please send me the link of the live stream? Thank you.
What is Outer Banks? Has anyone watched Squid Game yet?
Why are these confessions all about maths?
Of course.
Hold up. Let's go back. We're talking about Squid Game now. Go back.
Yeah, I have so many thoughts about Squid Game. Does anyone else want to engage in this conversation with me?
Yeah.
Hey, Seema, what did you think about that?
Don't.
Which, like, the end?
Hey.
did you leave having a massive crush on, like, everyone?
Yes. Yes.
No?
It's the best looking cast of any show.
The best looking cast.
The person who does the, what's his name? I watched him in another series.
Did you ever watch the movie Train to Busan? Because he's the main character.
Yeah, he is the main guy.
Yeah.
Great movie.
Next question. In year 11, I left school and missed maths to go to my ex-boyfriend's house. We have
ex-boyfriends.
Yeah, at the time, was it current boyfriend? Person.
He was her boyfriend at the time, now ex.
Right.
I was like, no, bad.
I kind of also want to go Serena.
Hey!
You're in my math class.
Yeah.
Your class together. What's going on?
I skipped every chaplain's assembly in year 8 to play SimCity on my iPad because I really wanted to overtake a friend and get to level 31. A, Ellen. B, Zara. C, Yuching. Or D, Eleni.
Only because I think it'll be really funny if it's her.
I can't even imagine little year 8s doing this.
SimCity. Great game.
Why are we saying Yuching?
I feel like she's the most unsuspecting one, which will be really funny if it's her.
And why are we saying Eleni?
I get the vibe from just the wanting to overtake the friend on level 31, just like a real petty, like, I like the game Sims, but I'm like, I'm skipping chaplains so that I can beat this person.
See,
you're right. Oh. In year 9, I stole plants from my area and took them home to grow. We have Chelsea, Chantel, Christine, and Rianne.
Litchi, are you like super confident, is D?
No, I'm not confident at all. I was just like, it could happen.
Why are we saying Christine?
I just think that she'd care about the plants and
I agree with that.
School.
Although it says stole, not cared for.
Why are we saying Rianne?
Because Litchi said
Rianne. No, as in, I don't know, like similar thing. Maybe she really wanted to look after some plants and Rianne would be relentless. She would just take them. Why not?
All right. It is Rianne. I may have experimented with eggs in the common room and we all know how that turned out. Sophia, Simon, Wenwen, or Eliza?
Experimented with eggs in what way? Yeah, so what does that mean?
Cooking in the microwave?
Juggling eggs? Cooking eggs?
Very cool.
I don't know. I'm just going to go with a wild card.
Mr. Paz, you are right.
Oh, yes. Nice.
Sophia.
I just feel like Sophia would eat eggs.
In year 7, I put a cup of water over my head, triggering my teacher's tectonic plates into giving me a demerit point. We have Manisha, Iris, Sabrina, or Emily.
This time it's geography.
Geography rules.
We love demerit points. Demerit points are the best. Points.
Yeah.
I totally know how to put them on sector. Yep. Good time.
Good thing we're leaving.
Yeah.
I'm very confident with it. I went Emily straight away.
I just went D for demerit.
I said that joke like 5 minutes ago, Mr. Clark. Come on.
That's it. Thank you.
I was 21. That went quick.
That was 21.
That ended too soon.
Who won, yeah. Sienna?
Fifth place, we have Mr. Law.
Oh.
In fourth place, we have Miss Tan.
Oh. Well done, Miss Tan.
In third place, we have Miss Litchfield.
Oh. Well done.
Place, we have Mr. Paz and Mr. Clark.
Woo. Mr. Clark.
Nice.
And Singleton. So go Singleton.
No.
Go Singleton. I'm definitely, I'm in Singleton. Yeah.
Three, two, one. Yeah, I think everyone has. Has anyone signed out? Has anyone actually signed out throughout the whole year?
Someone might remember the last time.
The reception area is just too far to walk to.
Exactly. We're not in the end fan building anymore.
We're going to make it beach trip.
Counting down.
Oh, wait, we're counting down. Jackie, what did you do?
I was like,
I know what she did. I don't know.
I will never be light again. I will never be light again. I was like,
did you actually? That's from the movie.
No, they like, they can do that.
Was that you as well, Chance?
No, I got a detention because I wore a different jumper on top of my school uniform. And then I got caught and like Poiser ran out after me, like outside of the gate, and I had like my hair dyed at the same time. So she was like, oh, I gotta dye my hair back. And then I got detention and they just made me like push tables and chairs around in like a full stop for like an hour.
What? How are you guys not?
I can't be doing this like every week.
Yeah.
What about during lockdown? Surely you've like stayed in bed.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, all the time. But like in real life too, we used to do that. But we have a lot of period ones, which is good. But we still end up doing that.
I do that all the time. I've done that so many times. Even like throughout school, just all the time. I'll just wake up like, yeah, no, I don't feel like it today. Going at recess.
Ready? Oh. Am I the only one? I've done cookies, I've done candy, I've done chips, I've done my lettuce.
Lettuce?
I fold it into my skirt and then just sit, and because we're sitting for most of assembly, and I just like, you know, up the sleeve, just not up the sleeve, but like hide it behind your blazer sleeve or your scarf or something.
Karen, was the lettuce folded in your skirt?
Well, I had a paper towel like covering it, and I would just put it in my lap.
That is so rare.
Okay. Again, only me. Wow.
How many people was it to?
Oh, I don't know. It was something that Lion sent out. So it's either a whole cast or the whole school.
Remember that. I remember it. And I thought, not Karen. She's one of the good ones.
It would have been your 8 or your 9. Oh, yeah, you're 8 or you're 9, yeah.
go.
I mean, it wasn't an accident because it was my mom.
Cheating. Ooh, majority yes. No Jack. Oh,
Jackie's the only strong
Jackie?
One.
Jackie has no emotions.
Jackie's always calm.
Ooh.
I mean, probably some RE takes from tradition.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh,
okay.
We're talking
yeah.
about that.
Okay.
Ooh, we have some good children.
I doubt it, Amelia, you liar.
Yeah.
Really?
I just sleep in. I don't pretend to have technical difficulties.
Oh, okay.
Well, what about to get out of book club, Amelia?
Hey, I am committed, Ella, actually. And guess who's not attended this year? You.
I have, just not online.
Take care of your relationships. Friends, make sure that you are kind to them. At the end of the day, if you are surrounded by loving people that care for you and you can trust in, then you know you really can overcome most challenges. And don't worry too much about challenges. If you really are faced with a hard situation in the future, no amount of stressing about it in advance is going to help you. And be here now and enjoy here now.
Hi, Year 12. I just wanted to send a quick message to you all and congratulate you for completing not only your BCE, but also your schooling as well. I know it's been a really challenging 2 years in particular for you. I knew when I was your YLC in Year 10 that you were a really, really special group of people. And you've certainly showed that over the last 2 years. I know it has been challenging. I know we've had to build up some resilience that we didn't know we would need. What I'd love for you to do now is to really enjoy your summer break and best of luck as you move towards your future study and employment as well. Congratulations once again, everyone.
Congratulations, Year 12, on reaching this amazing milestone of completing your BCE and being so resilient over these 2 years. My advice going forward is to spend time finding who you are. Embrace your individuality. Get to know what your intuition says. Don't be who the world says you should be, but be your amazing self.
To my gorgeous psychology girls, I have loved spending every minute of my time with you. I even feel that I can reduce my coffee intake just knowing that I'm coming to class because you all give me an extra pep in my step. I've loved the journey I've shared with you in teaching you psychology. I want you to keep taking good care of your brains, keep true to yourselves, enjoy life, enjoy all the experiences that are to come, and forever love psych and coffee and, of course, slots.
Hello, class of 2021. This is a short message, I guess, for you reflecting on your time or my kind of thoughts of your time. I have so many great memories with all of you over the, I guess, those 4 years. So I guess in that, when you were in year nine, I had the pleasure of teaching about 16 of you, I think, maybe 17, for accelerated mathematics in that year. We won't talk about the questionable class sorting between my class and Mr. Trufus, but I can honestly say that I loved teaching this class every day, even if Sophia could be a little too enthusiastic about math sometimes. I also remember a number of you crying in this class in term one, and that was really worrying for me. What was also worrying was how hard it was to convince Sienna to get glasses and then to actually wear them. Anyway, in year nine, I also went on camp with a small group of you to the Murray River, What's Up Men. Had a great time with an amazing camp group. I also remember Karen collecting a copious amount of firewood every afternoon without being asked and without complaint, even when no one else would help her. When you're in year 10, I had the most amazing science class. I clearly had an agenda in this class to recruit you all to VCE Physics. I do think it worked, but I loved our learning journey together in that year, and I was exceptionally proud of Eleni's exam results for semester two. She absolutely smashed it, and it was one of the prouder teaching moments for me. So I guess 2020, you guys started VCE, and I think we smashed remote learning together. I had a methods class and a spec class, and I really, really enjoyed teaching a lot of you in both of those classes. When we were at school, we had a classroom that I felt was, you know, full of joy and laughter and, of course, lots of learning. And then this year, honestly, it's been a challenge, and I don't think I could have gotten through it without my two amazing Year 12 classes. So to my physics class, Sarah, Esther, Alyssa, Kathy, Brina, Aline, Karen, Ash, Eliza, Izzy, Cynthia, and Holly, as well as my Year 12s in my methods class, Zoe, Renee, Sienna, Min, Arne, Tiff, Georgia, Michaela, Manisha, Izzy, and Holly again. Thank you all so very much for making the best out of this year. I really could not be prouder of all of you and of how hard you have worked and how much you have had to persevere through. It's been amazing to watch you all grow up so much over the last 4 years. Your resilience and your determination that you've shown through this year is an absolute testament to the incredible young women you have all become and will continue to be once you leave CGGS. So I really can't wait to hear what is next for all of you. This is definitely not a goodbye, but more a see you soon. Best wishes for your exam and an amazing future. Also, I haven't put a bow tie on for a while, so I hope you appreciate that I got dressed up for you. Bye.
Hi, girls. I just wanted to say that I'm really going to miss you next year. I've loved teaching lots of you while you've been here at CGGS, and I hope that when you get out there post-COVID, you really live it up and really enjoy all the spoils that life has to offer. I look forward to seeing lots of you back here at a reunion at some stage soon. But in the meantime, take care and have lots of fun. Bye.
I've been moving calm, don't start no trouble with me. Trying to keep it peaceful is a struggle for me. Don't pull up at 6 a.m. to cuddle with me. You know how I like it when you loving on me. I don't wanna die for them to miss me. Yes, I see the things that they wishing on me. Hope I got some brothers that outlive me. They gon' tell the story, shit was different with me. God's plan, God's plan. I hold back, sometimes I won't, yeah. I feel good, sometimes I don't, ay, no. I finesse down Western Road, ay, yes. Might go down to G-O-D, yeah, wait, yeah. I go hard on Southside G, yeah, wait. I make sure that Northside E. And still, bad things. It's a lot of bad things that they wish and they wish and they wish and they wish and they wish on me. Bad things. It's a lot of bad things that they wish and they wish and they wish and they wish and they wish on me. Yeah. Hey, hey. She say, do you love me? I tell her only partly. I only love my bed and my mom, I'm sorry. 50 dub, I even got it tatted on me. 81, they'll bring the crashers to the party. And you know me, turn the 02 into the 03, dawg. Without 40 Ollie, there be no me. Imagine if I never met the broskies. God's plan, God's plan. I can't do this on my own, ayy, nope, ayy. Someone watching this shit close, yup, yeah, close. I've been me since Scarlet Row, ayy, bro, ayy. Might go down as G-O-D, yup, yeah.
You just started.
I go hard on South
Side. You ate the BLT too much.
I make sure that Northside E, yeah. And still.
Yeah.